make this point because I believe there are two quite important developments in our understanding of the material world which provide a means for gaining further insight into the Baha'i teachings. And I want to begin tonight.
And I didn't know what the Baha'i teachings were. I didn't even know what the Baha'i teachings were.
These two concepts, and from there proceeding to seeing their application in the understanding of the Baha'i teachings. The first physical concept, which I think has great bearing on our understanding of the operation of the Baha'i faith, is what is called in the physical world the concept of non-linearity. Now, what does this mean? Very simply, and physicists in the audience will cringe at this explanation. Very simply, as I understand it, we think unconsciously of the world as a linear world. And a linear world is one in which a small cause produces a small effect. If you want a big effect, you need a big cause. If one person can lift 50 pounds, you need 10 people to lift 500 pounds, 100 people to lift 5,000 pounds, and so on. Our concept of the world and its operation and what happens in it is governed by our general perception that the world is linear. Small things produce small effects, big things produce big effects. Now it has become clear that this concept of a linear world is in many instances invalid. In some instances it is a useful approximation, in other instances not so. It has become quite clear over recent years to physical scientists that the world is essentially non-linear. And what does that mean? It means that in certain instances in the physical world, a very small force will produce a vast change. Looking at it in greater detail, mathematicians find that it depends upon what they call initial conditions. And what that means is that if you have a very, very small force, subject to the right conditions, whatever they are, subject to the right conditions, you can achieve a vast transformation in effect. This has become a very fashionable and very intriguing concept recently. The most recent meeting of the American Academy for the Advancement of Science was devoted almost entirely to this subject, and to a derivative of it called chaos theory and fractal mathematics and all kinds of other things that we need not worry about. But in the main, the understanding of the physical world, of the biological world, and now of the world of social sciences is being revolutionized by the realization that the world is basically non-linear. The things which formerly seemed mysterious, random, unpredictable, are in fact due to small forces, small changes applied at the right time and under the right conditions and in the right place. And the implications on that, of our understanding of the universe, are far from fully explored. The other physical concept that I think has great relevance to our understanding of the Baha'i faith is again the realization in recent years that the world around us is not as it seems, that it is basically, the material world is basically energized by unseen forces operating in a way which appears to defy common sense. Physicists looking deeply into the operation of the material world, have come up with a vast apparatus of concepts of forces and weak forces and strong forces, electromagnetic forces and gravitons and quantum mechanical concepts and all kinds of things, which at first sight don't seem to fit in with what we have learnt from experience, but which generally now are accepted to be true in the light of their ability to explain and their ability to predict new phenomena. It has become clear that our sense perception of the world around us is invalid. That deep beyond our sense perception is a world of forces operating in ways that don't fit in with our generally accepted understanding and which stretch our credulity. So, the material world, the world of physics, of biology, and of the social sciences is in great flux, is subject to tremendous change and revolution under the impact of these two relatively new principles. The application of the principle of non-linearity, that sometimes small forces at the right time in the right place produce vast effects, and the realization that the world we perceive is much more than it looks, that it is subject to mysterious forces which don't fit in with conventional views of common sense. I mention this because to me it is an example of the way in which the world is moving in the direction of making the Baha'i claims appear far more reasonable than they did to the casual observer even a few years ago. In the coming of Baha'u'llah, we see the principle of non-linearity operating par excellence. The appearance of his revelation at the right time, in the right place, under the right conditions, in an obscure part of the world, buried in the 19th century, is now transforming the affairs of mankind, creating great institutions, changing the world of today, and even more, the world of tomorrow.